We think about them every day, calories. But if you ever stop to think what a calorie actually is a unit of measure? Well, let's find out once and for all. Firstly, it's important to remember that a calorie isn't a tangible thing you'd find in food or drink, like protein or carbs, for example. It's a metric unit we often use for measuring the energy value of food and drink, or the energy expenditure of a human body through exercise or involuntary activity. As a unit of measure, one small calorie is the amount of energy required to heat 1 milliliter of water by 1 degree centigrade. Whereas one large calorie is the amount of energy required to heat 1 liter of water, which is 1,000 milliliters, by 1 degree centigrade. Now, food packaging uses the large calorie unit of measure when stipulating its calorie content. So it's always best for consumers to use large calories to measure with. So, what we're saying is, if you filled the kettle with 1 liter of water, which is 1,000 milliliters, to make a round of teas, it would require 100 calories to bring that water up to boiling point, which is 100 degrees centigrade. That's your temperature change, 0 to 100 degrees, times the volume of water, 1,000 milliliters, which equals 100,000 small calories. Then divide that by 1,000 to convert it to large calories, and that equals 100 large calories to heat 1 liter of water to 100 degrees centigrade. So let's put that into perspective. The amount of energy required to heat our litre of water up to boiling point requires the same amount of energy you'd find in half a Mars bar, just under a full can of cola, 2 apples, or 50 stalks of celery. Makes you realise, doesn't it, how dense in energy some of these food and drinks can actually be. Now, on the flip side, to burn 100 calories worth of energy, that's equal to 10 minutes worth of light cycling or 10 minutes worth of running. Now, for those still using the imperial system, or even worse, the imperial and the metric system, a large calorie is the amount of energy required to heat 33.814 fluid ounces of water by 33.8 degrees Fahrenheit. And it's also worth remembering, this is based on the temperature change happening in a controlled environment, and doesn't take into account factors such as energy waste. For example, heat escaping from our kettle through the spout or sides during the heating process. So it would likely require slightly more calories to heat water in a domestic environment. However, the takeaway message is, by the most common standard, 1 calorie is the amount of energy required to heat 1 liter of water by 1 degree centigrade. Okay guys, thanks for watching, and if you want to learn more, check out my episode exploring why society today is so much more overweight than in the 1950s, looking at changes in lifestyle and what we eat, and how it's led to an obesity epidemic.